2 years ago. Home is still England, folks. Home is still the hometown of Walsall, which is just outside of Birmingham in the Midlands region. As we talk now, I'm getting ready to go out to Spain, where Ken and Glenn are at the moment, and we'll start writing some new stuff out there for as long as it takes. So it's maybe 2 or 3 months a year in America, and then most of the time back home in England or in southern Spain. So it's like a 3 different places basically that you'll find priests working out of as far as recreation and work goes. The thing about me is I'm still a fan. I'm still a big fan and a music enthusiast of other people. But right now, the music scene in rock and heavy metal at the moment is pretty diverse. On the one side, you've got your Def Leppards and your Bon Jovis and your Poisons and your Whitesnakes all over here. And then on your other side, you've got your Slayers and your Anthrax and your Sacred Rites and your Cro-Mags and all these different people. And there doesn't seem to be any middle ground. And I'm hoping that something will come up that'll be, you know, an arena type act that'll move into that kind of area that I think is a bit empty at the moment. The thing about Priest is that we don't just lock ourselves off in one little area of, okay, we only listen to this and we only like that and we only like the other. We've always been very very open musically. You're getting these bells in the background. It's my local church. It's midday.
You're not the high priest of that church, by any
chance. No, but I do go to it now and again. I know the head honcho, Reverend Bob, who runs the place. It's a Methodist church. It's a nice church, actually. The thing about being in a situation where you're making, an album every few years, every 2 years or so, is that you're obviously given the opportunity to spend more time and more money on it, and it's very easy to fall into the trap of, you know, well, maybe we should do the guitars for the 8 millionth time or do the vocals for the whatever take. When you get down to the basics of what comes out of those speakers, I mean, I can get off just as much listening to British Steel, which is 5 weeks, or as I can to Turbo, which is 6 months.
One of my favorite ballads of all time, if you can call it, is Children of the Damned, off Number of the Beast, and like Beyond the Realms of Death by Judas Priest and stuff. Those are the ballads that I, as a singer, like, you know, sang in my room when I was a kid, you know, with a tennis racket and stuff, or tried to, you know, didn't really have the pipes when I was 13, but yeah, those, you know, really heavy ballads and not lyrically all about how lonely it is to be on the road when you're playing in front of, you know, 40,000 people a night. You know, it's kind of an ironic thing. Oh no, I gotta go on stage tonight, I'm so lonely. There's only 25,000 people in front of us. What the fuck you got to be lonely about, you know? So the subjects that are lyrically, you know, in these ballads are totally different than what we did on the first record. And, you know, I think it's more fun to do something that surprises people instead of exactly what they expect.
This album is, as I said, a lot heavier and stuff. Oh, that'll be for you.
Fuck off!
Yeah, it's heavier. I mean, we didn't sit there and say, okay, let's just make a heavy album for the sake of...
Hold on. Now!
And we didn't just do it just for the sake of doing a heavier record. I mean, it's everything that came out naturally, just like the first one was at that time. You know, we didn't write I Remember You because ballads were big. We wrote it because that's what we felt like, right? Yeah. So that's the same approach we took on this record as well.
But it's funny, like, I mean, if you only have one record out, if that's all you have to say in your whole musical career, then, you know, you must have fucking air for brains, you know? I mean, if that's all you got, those kind of songs, this type of music, every single record, well, what the fuck is the point of that, you know? Like, look at bands like Aerosmith, that like reinvent themselves with each record, or you know, even Motley Crue or something.
Queensryche, every record sounds different.
Yeah, it's
that's
like
cool. That's really
yeah,
cool.
And you're always going, man, I wonder what they're gonna do next. You know, there's like a little danger. Our next record could be all fucking banjo or something. You know, who knows?
And silver chrome souls dressed to the society. The hypocrite all beating cheap alibis.
Can you sort of have any sort of regrets at perhaps opening the door to all these bubblegum bullshit bands?
Well, if we opened them, we're closing them this year.
Yeah, that's for sure. It's a revolving motherfucker.
Yeah. No. No, there's nothing wrong. Like, we love our first record. You know, I was 19 when I sang that record, and I wasn't as focused. I don't think the band was as focused as we are now as far as, you know, when we play a song like Sweet Little Sister live or Peace of Me or Big Guns or, you know, any of the ones off the new record. It's a lot different vibe than, say, I Can't Stand the Heartache or the popular side. Like, we don't even do that song anymore because it's, you know, it's like a younger... Like the kind of a young, you know, it just doesn't feel right now. You know, at the time it did.
Yeah.
And maybe next year we'll go, holy shit, man. You know, that's a, you know, we'll do it. I don't know.
It's but, like when you do your first record, you don't know where the boundaries are, and I don't mean boundaries that you stay inside. It's the boundaries that you wanna step over.
Yeah.
And that's when you do your first record, you're just like in a studio, and you're like, oh my god, I'm working in the.
I'm making a record.
It's not another fucking demo, you know,
yeah.
And you just keep doing it, so. I mean, we're proud of shit of the first record.
Anytime people say, do this, the immediate reaction is saying,
no.
You know, that's the energy of rock and roll and the bands that we were influenced by. Like, you know, if you say you're influenced by Howling Wolf and Paganini, like some of these people, like, fuck you, you're influenced by Van Halen, man. Shut up, you know. Don't try to be pretentious.
Yes, I'm a blues man at the age of 17.
Fuck that. You know, sorry, we're influenced by Motorhead and fucking, you know, Cheap Trick. You know, excuse us.
I told all my friends, I said, if I change and get all stuck up and hung on myself, just take me in the backyard, put a shotgun right to the back of my head. You know, I don't think any of us had any serious lifestyle overhauls or anything.
No, we were assholes long before we made it.
Yeah, absolutely. But, I mean, we got houses, we got cars, but, I mean, you know, I ain't gonna say that we hate the money, because, you know.
Yeah, that's not, that's,
you know, that would be a total
lie.
But, I mean, we all live within, you know, 20 minutes of each other. It's not like one guy moved to L.A., another guy moved to Paris, you know.
I'm moving to Paris.
I'm moving to L.A.
Trick or treat.
Don't do the rubber.
Rob Mumbleback.
Whoa!
Very good score on my part, I'd say. This is going on my wall at home. So rock and roll.
Come on, baby, gotta win and stay. This is called sex golf. And you have to blow into it. So you gotta breathe some life into her. She's had a rough night.
Well, my luck, she could probably breathe some life into me.
I'm trying to figure out.
I'm trying to figure out.
Oh, yes!
She does?
Oh, there we go. Very convenient, isn't it? Yeah. It's kind of like a six-pack. You just pick them up. This, you just go walking down the street, singing. I'm trying to figure out it's a dollar, like some kind of wild hat.
You can keep on and take a whole bucket.
This is why people call me Tithead.
Guy, I got a present for you. Right.
Something you wanted for a long time.
Oh, yeah!
I've been looking for one of these for a while. Ship it A and 18 in life is what Ricky blew his friend away with. So don't kill your friends.
Hey, yeah, bud.
Oh, that's yours.
He was driving. He was in a mini.
He was in a mini.
Do you have any tree barking?
Tree barking?
I guess this is.
Oh! They even have the tree.
Elaborate on
that's.
This.
Elaborate on that's cold shit, man.
For me, I guess.
Baby snake.
Mark Ballin ended his life not around this tree, but around a tree that might have looked something like that. So we won't even talk about that.
This is the band here. Yeah, see, it says James Last plays Bach, and
it's James,
it's composer
Lamento
Sebastian Bach. And you know, it was really weird because I was reading a interview with Yngwie Malmsteen, and he named me as one of his influences. I was very honored. He said influences Mozart, Chopin, and Sebastian Bach. I was like, fuck, dude. It's beyond the Call of Duty. You're a righteous bro. So maybe I'll hum a little bit of Fugue 4. Right. Let's go something like.
Better than me.
That's just. Yeah. Then that happens.
This is the record that started it all, right?
Yeah, right.
Oh. Right there.
Yeah.
Right there.
Best picture of everyone.
Paying homage right here to the masters.
Trick or treat.
What about this part?
I remember putting like four things of toilet. Do you guys ever do the toilet paper in a car trick?
Yeah.
Like two trees, you know, you find a small road, like toilet paper go all the way across and make like this big wall of toilet
toilet paper and then your cars drive by. Either that or I remember one dude who was a little bit psychotic and he put like a wire mesh and a motorcycle came on.
Oh, nice.
That was a good memory. I think the guy probably died.
When I was 7 years old, I got my candy bar off by a guy with a board with a nail in it. I did. I was 7 years old. I took all my candy. I had nothing. So that's a really good memory of Halloween. Fuck.
I just remember being really cold and hitting your hand on, like, getting your hand stuck in the door and be like, yeah!
Ooh!
Oh.
What do we have here?
Moscow!
We have the Russian Moscow Festival.
Contrary to popular belief, they call it the Make a Difference Foundation, but some of